Now, space watchers are warning that China could launch 13,000 satellites to disrupt Starlink.
Meanwhile, China is working on a mega constellation of satellites. It plans to challenge Elon Musk's SpaceX.
Competition between the US and China. Well, that competition is now taking place on a new
Mysteries above. Who wins G60 and Starlink's battle in space? Two giants prepare for an interstellar showdown in a world where the sky isn't the limit. Can you guess the hidden ace up China's sleeve, waiting to challenge SpaceX's dominance? Stay tuned for a cosmic revelation that'll send shockwaves through the galaxy. Embark on a journey that ventures into the mesmerizing universe of satellite connectivity. This isn't just about science fiction dreams. It's a race to revolutionize internet access globally, with two major players fighting for the crown: SpaceX's Starlink and China's emerging G60. Stay with us and you'll uncover the motives behind China's sudden surge in space tech, the mysteries of the G60, and why the next frontier isn't just about exploration, but an exciting showdown. Prepare for a space saga that promises more twists and turns than the most gripping thriller. You won't want to miss a single moment. Dive in as we unravel a tale that's truly out of this world. SpaceX's Starlink, a visionary project led by the creative team at SpaceX, aims to transform how the world connects. Picture the skies above teeming with thousands of satellites, each roughly the dimensions of an office desk, forming a vast constellation in low Earth orbit. Their mission? To provide lightning-fast internet access to every corner of the planet. From scholars in the bustling cities to explorers in the remotest terrains, Starlink could be a beacon of connectivity. With its launch, we're starting a time when places without internet will now be filled with information. Every individual, regardless of location, can tap into the global conversation. This is not just technology, it's a revolution. But just as the world anticipates this new dawn, a shadow looms on the horizon. China, a global superpower, is less than pleased with this innovation. Why, you ask? The answer might not be what you expect, and it's a tale that will unravel later in the video. Now, back to the story. A lot of people see Starlink as a big step forward for everyone, but China? They're cautious. Why? First, they're worried about spying. In today's world, knowing stuff is very important. And with Starlink, it could be used to sneak a peek at what China is doing. Remember past times when the US got caught spying on other countries? That makes China more worried about Starlink. Also, there's the whole political side of things, which you need to know. But first, if this galactic drama hooks you, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to never miss out on tales like this one. During the initial stages of the Russia-Ukraine war, Starlink wasn't just an internet provider, but a lifeline. Russian forces' regular communication channels were disrupted as Ukraine was attacked aggressively. Starlink swiftly stepped in, ensuring that Ukraine's government and military units could seamlessly communicate. Beyond the tactical advantages, it played an indispensable role in keeping the Ukrainian public updated about the unfolding events of the war, bridging the gap between the conflict-induced communication blackouts. When discussing China's fear, let's not forget Taiwan, an island of strategic importance and a hotspot for geopolitical tension. Taiwan runs its own show, but China says, no, it's ours. Imagine Starlink giving Taiwan super-fast internet without any limits. That would be like boosting Taiwan's defenses and making it even more independent. But China really wants Taiwan back, even if they have to use force. So they're super careful about anything happening around Taiwan, especially Starlink. They think Starlink could be up to no good, like spying on them or messing with their military stuff. China isn't just worried, they've even said they might do something to Starlink satellites if they cause trouble. So in the middle of this tension and technological rivalry backdrop, the skies are becoming the new battlefield where both superpowers showcase their power and assert their interests. China isn't just sitting back and watching, especially regarding big space and tech projects. Enter Guo Wang. Think of it as China's version of Starlink. This ambitious project is being managed by the experts at the China Aerospace Science and Technology Corporation, CASC. They plan to launch satellites by 2023 and want the entire system up and running by 2030. Diving deeper, Guo Wang is supported by the heavyweights of the China Satellite Network Group, China SatNet, a top-notch state-owned enterprise. They've set some lofty goals, aiming for a vast constellation of roughly 13,000 satellites circling close to Earth. And these aren't just any satellites. They're equipped with advanced phased array antennas capable of sending and receiving data in multiple directions. This tech stands out from Starlink's more basic antennas. Importantly, Guo Wang isn't just for big cities. Instead, they have a vision to bring high-speed internet to remote spots in China and other parts of the world, bridging digital gaps. But wait, China's ventures in space aren't only about bringing the world closer to internet connectivity. A new and mysterious player has entered the scene, the G60. Developed as an answer to SpaceX's Starlink, also launching thousands of satellites into low Earth orbit, the G60 comes with its bag of mysteries and intrigue. But why? This story has a significant backdrop, so let's unravel it. Rewind to February this year. An article shed light on the G60 constellation. By the end of 2022, five test satellites of the G60 were already orbiting the Earth. Interestingly, four of these were connected to the Clio Connect project, a partnership between Chinese and European groups. For those who might not recall, a storm of controversy surrounded the Clio Connect initiative. There were big fights between the groups and legal issues, and the media said the project failed. After this failure, a company called Rivada took over some of Clio Connect's stuff. And here's something interesting. Rivada is not working with the Chinese groups. Instead, they're teaming up with Terran Orbital, which has strong ties to the US and Western Europe. With Clio Connect's spectrum now in Rivada's hands, and Chinese involvement looking unlikely with Rivada's plans, a question arises. Is the G60 project doomed before it even starts? Recent events, however, suggest otherwise. The plot thickens in the Songyang district of Shanghai. The Shanghai municipal government dropped quite a revelation in a recent press conference. Shang Jingmin, a top official in Songjiang, shared exciting news about speeding up the development of the G60 Starlink. Yes, you heard it right, they're using the name Starlink. Quite audacious, given that's what the world associates with SpaceX's project. Now, let's get to the meat of this. The official press release elaborates on the big ambitions behind the G60. It isn't just about launching satellites or merely providing internet connectivity. The G60 Starlink aims to create the globe's premier commercial satellite operation service platform. Beyond internet access, it's anticipated to support China's military intelligence operations and even spearhead the development of new space-based technologies. They're kickstarting this dream by building a digital satellite manufacturing plant, a satellite on-orbit operation center, and a satellite internet hub. Moving forward, while both Starlink and G60 showcase immense potential in reshaping global satellite communication, they aren't without their unique challenges. Here's a deep dive into some of these hurdles and how the two projects stack against each other. Technology. At the forefront, Starlink undoubtedly holds a technological edge. Thanks to years of development under SpaceX's belt, Starlink's technology has matured, showcased by the impressive deployment of over 2,000 satellites in orbit. On the other hand, the G60 is still trying to find its footing. Being in the early stages, China's G60 is a developing player, with uncertainties about when it'll reach full operational capability. Regulation. Navigating the regulatory systems is a challenge both these satellite projects face. While Starlink has gotten the nod from the U.S. Federal Communications Commission, FCC, to operate stateside, it's still awaiting clearance from numerous other nations. G60 hasn't confronted the same extent of regulatory scrutiny yet. Still, as the project picks up, it will likely run into some regulatory challenges involving approvals for it to operate smoothly in different parts of the world. Cost. The financial landscape landscape of these projects is another key differentiator. Starlink's aspirations come with a hefty price tag. Having already secured billions in funding, SpaceX's project is projected to cost several billion more until its completion. In contrast, G60's financial layout seems less daunting. Being a smaller endeavor, the costs associated with G60 are anticipated to be considerably lower than Starlink. Security. Security is one of the most sensitive areas where both projects face skepticism. There are whispers in international corridors about Starlink's potential misuse as a surveillance tool, a sentiment echoed by the U.S. government's apprehensions. Similarly, G60 is no stranger to security challenges. However, there's a prevailing sentiment that China, with its tightly controlled governance model, might find it slightly easier to tackle these security concerns than the more democratic US. But while everyone's busy watching the satellite race, there's a secret floating above us that could change everything. What's China hiding up there? In the midst of preparing for a tech-savvy future with G60, China has got a few more tricks up its sleeves. Imagine the scene. High above Earth, where satellites float, a new kind of weapon lurks, ready to defend China's space turf at any cost. Yes, you heard it right. China isn't just working on matching Starlink satellite for satellite. They're also ready to protect their space boundary with anti-satellite weapons. These aren't ordinary gadgets. They're specially designed to possibly knock out Starlink satellites if they ever cross the line. The message is loud and clear. China won't tolerate spying or interference in its operations. It's like a cosmic showdown with satellites instead of guns. There's another twist. While the world is grappling with space laws and regulations, China is crafting its space laws. Picture this. Lawmakers in Beijing are sitting down to write a brand new set of rules, a playbook, all about how the sky above us can be used. This space law is like setting up boundary lines, deciding who can play in China's space backyard and how. It could mean that Starlink might find doors closed in China, with a big no entry sign posted in the sky. Through this, China is looking to claim ownership, setting up invisible fences in the sky that dictate who can come in and who can't. So, is China's G60 merely a shadow of Starlink or a powerful new challenger in the space race? As we watch the drama unfold high above us, China is not just aiming to be another player in the game. They're planning to be a game changer, weaving together high-tech plans with clever strategies to make a grand entry into the world of space tech. With every move, the suspense thickens as two giant forces get ready for a face-off in the final frontier of space. Folks, fasten your seatbelts because the next few years promise to be a roller coaster ride in the cosmic playground. If you don't want to miss out on witnessing this epic space race, remember to hit that subscribe button and join us on this journey through the stars.